Is that Harden Scott?
Harden, you have two options here. Either you fuck me or you leave. You decide. You hurt me and I can't forgive you.
So last night meant nothing?
I didn't know what I was doing from kissing that guy.
Why? Tessa would never kiss a stranger at school.
There is no you're Tessa anymore.
Congratulations on the film. It is so much sexier from the first one. My gosh, like Hero and Josephine, some of those scenes are so steamy. Were they hard to film? Were they awkward?
We say this a lot, but I personally don't. I think that for me, scenes where you have to be emotionally vulnerable can be more difficult than scenes where you have to be physically vulnerable. But I think when you're doing them with someone where you already have a pre-existing sort of dynamic and you've done this before, and when you're doing them in a professional environment, it's very technical and it's very much like any other scene.
Dylan, I really like you in this role. You do it good in a suit. Trevor is very smooth in his interactions with Tessa in the elevator. Back in the day, were you that smooth in real life when it came to flirting?
No, actually, not even a little bit. I was a larger than average child. My teenage years were spent consuming lots of tapioca pudding. And I was never a hit with ladies. Actually, my brother was quite the ladies' man. I never learned. And by the gods, it's a miracle that I managed to have the girlfriend that I have today. But I put a lot of acting into use to try and play that smooth.
Hero, I spoke to you during the press conference for the first film, and you said one of the biggest lessons you learned in a relationship was to be honest. Was it harder playing Harden in this film? Because as we see, he's not so honest at times.
Yeah, no, it's a good question. I guess, when your character does something that you don't necessarily agree with personally, such as like being honest in a relationship, you kind of have to detach your own opinions from it when you're playing the role. And I guess that almost put yourself in a position where you completely agree and back everything that they do and say. So I guess I kind of got myself to a place where I understood the reasoning as to why he wouldn't be like that. So maybe it was a bit of a challenge at the start, but I think you really just got to put yourself in their shoes and fully like back all of their thoughts and actions. And I do think I think I did it.
I think you did as well. I love all the three accents in this. Mm-hmm. Back over to the Australian though, Josephine. Tessa is so grown up in this movie and she's always had like a great moral compass. But in this installment, she's, I think, far more confident within that and within herself. As an Australian, and you've stepped into, you know, this other world that is Hollywood, was there a moment where you, like Tessa, really started to sink into your own confidence?
No, I still think I'm dealing with it, to be honest. You get used to things and you learn things, and then you slowly get, it becomes the new normal. Like, I'm dreadful at some dreadful, but I'm getting better at answering questions in a sort of coherent way with the normal sentence structure. It's something I usually struggle with.
No, you're doing really well.
Thanks. Thank you so much.
Very powerful in this film as well, like, because she gets quite angry. The question for you all, when it comes to matters of the heart, do you generally follow your head or your heart?
There's lots of different organs that I think come into play. but yeah, I think it's a sort of half and half situation. You have to be logical about things, but you also have to, there's no point being with someone who's perfect on paper, but you have no feelings for.
I actually have like a, because I'm very scatterbrained, I have a list I go through when I'm thinking about jumping into doing something that I've learned from all the mistakes in my past of not doing, which is like, am I hungry? Am I sleepy? Am I angry? And I ask myself like a list of questions. And then after I've deduced all of that, I go into making the action and I still ignore everything that I talk to myself about. and do it with the heart anyway. So it's, yeah, it's weird. I like to pretend that I use my head.
What was one of your favorite scenes to film, all of you?
It was really nice doing the frat scenes with a bunch of the cast, because we're all sort of the same age and we hadn't gotten to see them in such a long time. So, I mean, I know that's a classic answer, but it's always really nice reuniting with people that, and yeah, so I think the party scenes were fun.
Josephine, if you were Tessa, would you have gone for Harden or Trevor?
Me, Josephine, I picked the third option, and I picked myself. and I picked being single.
What are you talking about when you say you're not good at these answers? That's very good. Generally speaking, all of you, do you guys opt for a more sensible kind of love or the crazy, all-consuming kind?
I think it's a balance. I think it could be one or the other, but I think I personally would need both.
I would say crazy or consuming, but then when you get older, maybe it's a little more of the more sensible.
I sort of feel like a 60-year-old woman already. So at the moment, I'm ready to, like, you know, settle down, cup of tea.
You want sensibility, right? But you also don't want a stick in the mud. Like, I feel like you have to have someone who's a little bit crazy in some way.
You need the crazy to match your crazy.
Yeah. So. And you guys seem to all get along. What was the dynamic like on set when you were filming?
It's very different. We've had to force this ability.
We hate each other. We're just, I guess it's work, isn't it? So we find a way.
We're paid to like each other.
Right. Look, thank you so much. That's time for us. Enjoy the rest of this very strange virtual press conference. And congratulations again on the film. You guys are great.
Thank you so much.
Thing between you and Harden, it's not gonna end well.
Whatever our souls are made of,
his and mine are the same.
There's no one else for me, Tessa. No one.